One of the best men on the ground was Casey Adams, who played cross halfback today. That second half, mate, you were sensational. You just kept repelling move after move after move. You must be delighted to win that.
Yeah, mate, it's been a long season. Like, a few of these old boys are finally stepping up. It's been a long year. We've been carrying the club for the last 10 years, but now we're starting to see the youth coming through. And
carrying the club?
these boys are the future, and they really stepped up today. And I think this hard season's going to really see them succeed in the next few years.
When you were 17 points down, did you feel it was slipping away, or you still had the confidence that you could find a way?
It's been a good warm-up today. We sort of having a bit of a joke before the game. This weather, obviously, not really good conditions, but we just had a good bunch of boys, a bit of a laugh, and we just knew we could get the job done if we played as a team and stuck to our structures. We're sort of good in tight, so this wet weather really is really good for us, I think.
Do you like the wet weather? Because you seem to read the play better than most, particularly in the second half.
Yeah, I don't mind the wet weather. I think these smaller grounds suit me a bit better too. It's sort of a bit less ground I have to cover these days, so I'm really happy with the win.
You just held firm because they were coming, but you made your forward 50 entries hard, didn't you, in that last quarter in particular?
Yeah, we just thought if we locked down here, I don't think they've got enough avenue for goals these days, so we just did our job, gritted it out, got a good win.
Did you remember the theme song all right?
Yeah, it's been a while, but yeah, we got it done. Had to teach a few of these new boys the song. Nah, I really appreciate it, fellas, anyway.
Good on you, Casey. Congratulations. Good luck for the rest of the year. Thanks, mate. Well, what a win this was by the Healsville Footy Club. They came from the clouds, 17 down. Late in the third quarter, I've got the playing coach, Simon Gordon. I've got the hero, Rodney Woodford. You kicked 6 goals, Rod. Well done. Did you think you're in trouble? 17 down, close to three-quarter time?
Well, we've been in a few games at halftime this year, and then we've sort of faded away, so I'm just super proud of the boys. We've had a pretty tough year. Blokes keep dropping off, going away, getting injured, but the blokes have hung around and stuck fat, and it's good reward for those boys. So just bloody thrilled that we got there in the end.
You had self-belief, obviously, at three-quarter time with those two late goals.
Well, absolutely. Like, it's one thing about the group. Like, it's funny, when we haven't won a game this year, but it's probably been one of the most enjoyable years in terms of the boys who come with the right attitude to training and turn up every week. And, you know, everyone's got no big expectations in terms of win-losses, but everyone's just having a crack, so that's all we can really ask for.
Simon, you've been involved in footy a long time. Where does that win rate?
I was the first win as a coach, so it's pretty high. Yeah, pretty close to one behind the grand final that we won a couple of years ago. I've been in a couple of close ones here over the years, so it's good to actually get over the line. They're hard to beat here. Upwey, they play their ground really well. So right up there.
It was terrific, those two goals just before three-quarter time. Did you get the feeling, addressing the players at three-quarter time, that you could get the run on and overrun them in the last quarter?
Like Rock said, we've been in it at halftime a lot and sort of faded in that third quarter. And then one thing we have done all year is run the game out really well. I don't know what the stats would be, but I think we'd be pretty close to goal for goal in the last quarter through the year. So, I had the confidence that we had the legs, a couple of their little injuries, little niggly injuries, and they sort of late in the third quarter there and early in the last probably helped a little bit. But, you know, you take those wins.
The back line, Rod, held firm, didn't it? Fantastic in the last quarter because they were coming. They kicked 1-9 in the last quarter, but your defence was superb.
Yeah, they rock solid. The boys, Mitch Hay, Casey Adams, like, you win your premierships and you win your game, start in the back six. So those boys just didn't give in, kept marking it, kept locking it in. So, you know, one for the back line, we wouldn't have got up today, I don't reckon. And it hurts me to say that as a forward too. So, yeah, but I'll give him credit today.
What's it mean to kick 6 goals in a win too?
Oh, no, it's fantastic. I've had a good week. I had my first son was born.
Yeah, I heard that. Congratulations.
So it's been a whirlwind week, so it's been fantastic. Just delighted to do me a bit. Like, there's been blokes like Gordo have sort of stood up this year and said, oh, you know, I'll help the club out, I'll do the thing. And, you know, there's a lot of people that have left and gone and done different things for different reasons, but the blokes that have stuck around really deserve this win, so just fucking wrap for everyone.
What do you reckon, Simon, for the rest of the year now? I mean, what sort of momentum or impetus could this win give you?
Give us a bit of run. We've got a couple of guys. We've got Axe Caraccio's going overseas tomorrow, and Nick Mendy's got a motorbike race next week. So we've got a pretty hard July, but, you know, we can only go out there and do what we can do.
Congratulations, boys. Great win. I hope the young fella sleeps well for you, Rod, and no doubt you'll have a good night tonight. Well done on a terrific performance, boys.
And they're finding it all on the mind of the monk. Now I'm to improve on their forwards and their
Get your game face on.